Dr. Maria Klawe, thank you for talking with us.
It's a pleasure to be with you, Judy.
So when it comes to women, girls and women, and going into the sciences, what happens in this country? Because we look at what's happening in high school and college, and there are so many more young men who are moving in that direction than young women. Why is that?
Well, we get lots of young women going into chemistry and biology. Many of those think they're going to go to med school afterwards. But we get very few young women going into computer science and physics and areas of engineering. And we even know the reason why it's the case. It's because, number one, they think it's not interesting. And number two, they think they wouldn't be good at it. And number three, they have this image of the people in those fields that they don't think is attractive. And what we encourage our young people to do in this country is follow your passion. Well, if you don't think it's interesting and you don't think you do well at it, would you go there? Probably not.
But why is it that boys in school, young men, think it is interesting and young women don't? What's the difference?
Because
there?
I think the image is that this is a boy thing. So, for instance, if you we've done lots of research on children as in elementary school, in middle school, and in high school. And if you ask girls and boys, say, about computers, they'll all say it's a boy thing. Not using computers. Everybody uses computers and phones and slates and stuff like that. But when they think about actually becoming somebody who would create things with computers, who would actually study computer science, both boys and girls think that's something that boys do.
Why does it matter that we have more girls interested in the science?
That's such a great question. So for me, there are really three reasons. The first one is these are amazing careers. Particularly right now in computer science, the job opportunities are incredible, and it doesn't matter. I mean, it's not just about going to work for a place like Google or Microsoft or Facebook. It's about doing computer science and medicine, or doing computer science and arts, or doing computer science and languages, or doing educational software. So the first thing is the careers are out there. They pay really well. They're very flexible. Great opportunities to combine a career with family. So, you know, I hate that young women don't get that opportunity. The second one is what gets created in technology today depends on who's doing the creation. I'll talk about computer games for a moment. So for a very long time, virtually all the computer games were built by young men and somewhat older men, and played by young men and somewhat older men. And so we had shoot-em-ups, we had lots of violence, we had sports. Now, all of a sudden, what has happened is the game publishers and the game developers and the Nintendo and Sony and so on have realized that the market for video games has plateaued. And so now they're going after young women and older women. And all of a sudden, we're seeing games that are really fun. So the first example is The Sims, which came out of Electronic Arts and became the most popular computer game ever played. A lot of the people associated with The Sims were female.
But it's a bigger issue than playing games. I mean, that's important, but it's also the skills that
It's you know, what kind of user interfaces do we have? It's what kind of medical devices get created. I mean, it's just the whole idea is if you completely shut out the entire feminine perspective on the world, you're going to have a different set of products.
You've been working on this for years. So, I mean, you said a minute ago they don't think it's interesting. How do you get them interested, and how do you make them confident that they can do it?
Well, let me answer in two ways. If I could wave my magic wand and just change the world right this second, I would change the way that the media portrays careers in science and engineering, because we tend to think of those people as dorks and dweebs and geeks and nerds, etc. And I would show them the way back in the 70s we started to show doctors and lawyers, where there were women and men who had lives, who fell in love and out of love and had all kinds of problems. And all of a sudden we saw the numbers of women going into medicine, into law, skyrocketed, and it's basically 50-50 now. So that would be the easy solution. Seems to be a difficult nut to crack.
Changing the image.
So what I actually recommend right now is, the problem is if you do a program at the middle school level and you get girls interested, they've got another 4 years of high school for peer pressure to get them disinterested again, and it mostly happens. So my recommendation is you actually do it right when they enter college. You get them into an intro computer science course that is absolutely fascinating and fun and creative, and you have them have so much fun that they just can't believe that this is really computer science. And that's actually what we've done at Harvey Mudd College, because we have all kinds of students who arrive saying, I hate computers, but they have to take a computer science course in the first semester. And halfway through the semester, I'll be asking them, what do you think? What's your favorite course? And probably 90% say CS5. I hate computers. I hate computing. But oh my God, that's the greatest course ever.
So what about to those parents who are watching?
My message is, number one, try it. Because you won't know until you've tried it. And also, you know, go into it. And if there are some male students in the class who seem to know way more than you do, ignore it. Because they tend to show it off more. Look for an instructor who is encouraging, because that makes a huge difference. And, you know, I have had so many female students in my life who I talked into taking their first computer science course. And they're so grateful. They're going like, oh my God, I have these great career opportunities. I can do anything. I can travel around the world. But they had to take the first course.
And finally, a question about the national agenda. You participated in a conference at the White House where the president talked about the importance of science and math in school, the importance of students studying that. How important is this whole question of not just women, but elevating science, math, and engineering in this country in terms of the future of the United States?
When you think about where the economic opportunities are, it completely demands that we have to have a workforce that is skilled in science, engineering, and mathematics. We do not have a future unless we achieve that. And unfortunately, we graduate many fewer scientists and engineers and mathematicians than our competitors do. So I truly believe that if we are to have the kind of future that we've had in the past, we have to address getting more young people to major in these areas. We have to improve our math and science teaching in our schools.
Maria Klawe, president of Harvey Mudd College, thank you very much for talking with us.
It's been a great pleasure. Thank you for having me.